This is the sit-up. For the sit-up, we're gonna lay down flat on our back. Our legs are fully extended out. Our arms are gonna be fully extended out. From here, we're gonna slide our heels to our butt. As we do that, we're gonna throw our arms over our head and freeze at the top. Once I get to the top, my heels are to my butt, my fingertips are touching, and my chest is up. From here, I'm gonna kick back out, back to the lying position. This is the hollow hold. For the hollow hold, we're gonna lay down, we're gonna raise our legs up. We wanna have our toes pointed away from us, and our legs up over our waist. From here, we're gonna reach up and try and touch our shoelaces or as far as we can go. The goal here is to keep our shoulders off the ground. If the shoulders come down, your abs are not engaged. So we want the shoulders up off the ground and keep reaching and pulling your chest towards your feet. How? These are knee raises. For the knee raises, we're gonna lay on our back. We're gonna put our hands underneath our butt, and we're gonna extend our legs out so they're 6 inches off the ground. From here, we're gonna drive our knees in to our chest and then lift our butt off the ground, kicking back out to an extended position. This is the L-sit. For the L-sit, we're gonna wanna sit up nice and tall. Our legs are fully extended, point the toes away. From here, we're gonna put our hands out in front of us. It is very important that we don't have our hands behind us. We want our hands out in front of us as much as possible. As we put our hands out in front, we're gonna lean forward, keeping our chest up, and lift ourselves off the ground. As I'm up, I do not want to drop my butt down. I want to keep my butt off the ground. Again, hands in front, lean forward and lift. Good. This is the seated twist. For the seated twist, we're going to bring our knees in, and we're going to sit up nice and tall. We're going to start with a light weight. It does not have to be heavy. From here, we're gonna hold on to that weight and we're gonna lean back just a little bit. You might wanna put something underneath your butt just in case to keep a little bit of padding there. So from here, I'm gonna twist across my body and touch the floor and then come back across the other side. So as I'm doing this, I'm actually twisting at my torso. I'm not just moving my arms. This doesn't do anything for my core. I have to twist across my body and come back. See the twist. These are planks. For the planks, we're gonna start with the front plank. We're gonna put our forearms on the ground. The key here to doing planks is to make sure that your shoulder is over your elbow and then you bring your legs out. Feet together so you can squeeze your butt cheeks tight. Now, it's critical. When you do a plank, we do not slope our lower back. If we do, we're gonna put all the weight on our lower back and it's gonna cause pain. So we wanna squeeze our belly and squeeze our butt cheeks tight as we do our planks. We don't wanna be here. We don't wanna be here. This is where we wanna be. This is the front plank. From here, I'm gonna get to my side plank. I'm gonna put my hand down. My shoulder is directly over my hand. My leg, under leg is out. And then I put my other foot on top. This arm comes straight up in one line to my other hand. To make this more difficult, I'm gonna raise my leg up and back down. This will be much more harder. These are plank walkouts. We're gonna start in a push-up position where our hands are underneath our shoulders. Our feet are actually spread shoulder width apart. From here, I'm gonna walk my hands out and stay braced at the belly. I'm gonna continue to walk out, staying braced. To the point where I cannot hold anymore. The key here is keeping braced at the belly.